Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 9070 processor. I have a part number here. It's a IC697CPX772. Don't be concerned about the revision letters. This test will be the same for all of them. It's just a simple test. I'm going to go ahead and put this in the rack. And power it up. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to remove this door so that you can better see everything on the inside that I'm going to be pointing at. And the first thing I want to do is plug in. I'm going to be using a cable here, AS693232SNP. This is a programming cable connected to the computer. It has LEDs that flash when it's communicating. I'm placing that on port 3. I'm going to go ahead and connect up. Now it's communicating and it's connected up. If you are unable to connect, then there's obviously a problem with the processor, and this is something that we commonly repair here. Or we offer exchange program or new units that we can ship very quickly. So please see our website if you can't get connected and there's a bigger problem. You won't be able to follow this test. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to place the processor into run mode. And what I'm doing in the background is just going into a programming screen, clearing any processor or I/O faults. Don't clear any other information from your processor that you may need, such as flash memory, just I/O faults and processor faults. Now I'm going to go ahead and download and run. The processor is in an IC697CHS750 rack. The slots are empty because, again, this is just for the processor, and it's being powered by an IC697PWR711 power supply. And again, we can see this port number 3 talking. These LEDs are port 3, port 2, port 1, and I'll be going through that shortly. And as soon as this build is complete, we'll be able to get it in a run mode right now. So now, I have all three LEDs on, which means that the processor is, in fact, in run mode. The run mode is the middle LED. The bottom LED is I/O, inputs, outputs, enabled. And I want to test this toggle switch below the LEDs. And that lets me shut off the I/O or put it back into run mode. And all of those work. I also have, if you can see, a key on the top of the processor. This is for memory protect. I'm going to turn that on. And I should get an LED that comes on that tells me that my memory protect setting works. So that's fine. Now, last two tests, I want to make sure that all the ports work. So I'm going to unplug port 3, plug into port number 2, and immediately I have communication, so I know that that works, and I can see on my software screen that it's working. I'm going to unplug that and put it back. And last, I have a cable that fits to port number 1. This is IC693CBL316. It looks like a phone jack on one side, and on the other side is a serial cable that plugs into my computer. And as soon as I plug that in, I should get some sort of a response on the LED here. And we do, it's blinking, it's talking. So this is good. So all three ports work, all the switches work, and the processor can go into run mode. That's the basic test. Now, what I would recommend doing if you can get this far and you feel that the processor is a problem, I'd leave it running overnight or over a weekend, a couple days. And what you want to do is when you check back on it, you want to make sure or hope that it's still in run mode. If for any reason it kicks itself out of run mode, there's actually a problem with your processor. You can go into I'm using Prophecy Machine Edition, GE. You can go into Target on your top menu bar, into Diagnostics, and the Diagnostics screen will tell you why it fell out of run mode. Okay, I hope this video helped you. Thank you.